to keep faith with the king. You know, I was released specifically for medical treatment here. And they have released on parole, which means I have to go back. And I told the king that after the treatment I would return to prison and to face the trial. And then secondly, I have to keep faith with my own people, my comrades, people who have fought, who are fighting alongside me for the restoration of democratic rights. So these are the two reasons why I should go back.
What do you expect to happen to you when you go back?
You see, this is the king by when I'm facing serious charges. There are seven cases against me.
Charges of treason and trying to overthrow the government by force.
Yes. And each charge carries a death penalty.
That situation at the worst. Why don't you just stay in exile? Why are you so determined to go back?
First of all, this I told you, I think I have answered that question.
But I mean, in a personal way. I mean, you've got family, members of your family who are still in prison, I understand. Very close friends who are still there.
My friends are there. And there are warrants of arrest against some members. Like my eldest son is in exile in India, he can't go back. And then my youngest son is also facing charges of treason and all that. And my sister-in-law and one of my nieces in prison. She went back to Nepal with me and she's in prison. She's the only woman political prisoner in Nepal.
Wouldn't a lot of people in your present situation and circumstances understand if you chose not to go back?
So what will I do if I stay away, except care for my health? But if I am there, I think the very presence will have a political impact. Other than if I stay away, then I think my being a prisoner is more my contributing my share in the struggle for democratic rights.
Thank you. We have to end it there. Thank you very much for joining us. We wish you a safe journey. Thanks, Joe.